Hi, Julie here. I hope during the time of Corona that you can still find the inspiration to dance and find the love in your heart for it. My lecture today is going to be about spins and turns in quite a simple basic piece. And also at the end, to find your own interpretation. So are you ready to turn this world around? Okay, the choreography. It's quite simple actually. But it's not about the choreography. It's about the turns that we add to it, and we go from no turn onto a lot of turns. And different ways of going from the fan to the hockey stick. So let's do it. We start. Close, forward, forward. No spins in the beginning. We close again. Four, forward, forward, forward of turning and close the feet. Cucaracha, diagonal. Swivel, swivel, swivel. Step forward and just the feet. So this is the basic choreography, but we're gonna go a little bit further. So when we start again, we're gonna add a spiral. Spiral, walk, walk, back. Close, forward, forward. Spiral, forward, forward, close. We're going to add after this swivels, swivel, swivel, swivel. Just a quarter return there and back. And that's the beginning. Two, three, we're gonna add a three-step turn. Two and three and four. Two, three, four, one, forward, close, back. Cucaracha. Two, three, swivel. Two, three, four. Now, from here, we're just on the quarter of a turn. So now we're just gonna do a half of a turn. Two, three, four. Two, three, four. We're gonna close. We've done three-step turns, so we're gonna do a spiral three-step turn. Two, three, four. One, two, and three, and four. Two, three, four. One, two, and three, and four. Cucaracha. Two, three, four, one. Two, three, four, one. We just did a half a turn, so we're gonna do now one whole turn. So we just go two, three, four. And two, three, four. So now we're gonna do the chinoise. The chinoise is actually quite a, it's a ballet term. And it's a turn that's constantly closing the feet, yeah? So we're gonna do it. So then we go from here. Two, three, four, one. Two and then the three and four. Two, three, four. Two and then the three and four. Cucaracha. Two, three, four. Swivel, swivel, swivel. We're going to do now one and a half turns. Two, three, four. Two, three, four, one. Now the last one, we're going to add a spiral plus the chinoise. Yeah, so there we go. Two, three, four, one. Two and then a three and four, one. Two, three, four, one. Two and then a three and four. And this one you can either close the foot or step backwards. Yeah, cucaracha. Two, three, four, one. Two, three, four, one. And then we end, we've just done one and a half turns and two turns. Two, three, four, one. Two, three, four, one. So quite simple, yeah? It's not difficult, but it's just important to put in your brain, what am I doing? Am I doing a spiral? Is it about a three-step turn? Am I doing a half a turn? Am I doing a quarter of a turn? But to make it very, very precise. So now we're going to do it with music. always remember that it's not about how many turns you do, but how you do them. I want quality. So let's do that with music. The music I've chosen is from Tony Braxton, and the title is Do It. How appropriate is that? So let's get it done. Good luck. Beginning, it's not only about the choreography and spins and turns. That was the first part. Now the second part is about you. And what do you do with this piece of choreography? I've got six different ways that you can actually dance it. And the first way is about how good are your feet. So how beautiful can you actually make the feet? So for example, if you do the cucaracha with the swivels, just examples, is as soon as I do the cucaracha, zoom, what do I want to be seen? What do I want to show with that foot? How do I put my foot down? How do I pick the foot up? How does it pass? How do I go into the swivel? Zap, clear directions, swivel. The pushing off and the extension of the feet, but also on the end of a turn. So if I've done, for example, the standing spin, so if I've gone from here, just the half a turn, how do I look at the audience? Because you can practice that still at home. Look at a plant. No, I look at you, but I know what I'm doing with my foot. So that is all possible. That is the improvement you can also do at home. So again, beauty of feet. So I would advise you to go through this choreography and go through what am I doing with my feet. So if we do the cucaracha, that how do I actually put the foot down? How do I peel the foot off? How do I do my swivel? How do I put the foot on the floor? peel it off and extend it. Now we're going to talk about breath. What can I do with my breath? Well, for example, my flowers, tulips. I can smell them, breathing in and breathing out. So that's how simple it is. But how would we do that in dance? Very simple. We can breathe in through the nose, feel the energy coming higher, and breathe out through the mouth and release that energy. Yeah, so I'll do it without speaking, but I will really breathe. So, I can hold the breath. I can release the breath and catch the breath. And let it flow through that whole body. That's what I can do with breath. Another choice that you can make is the switching of energy. What I sometimes see, not everybody, but quite often, is this monotone energy. And very much about, I have to do it good, it has to be perfect. But it's a little bit boring. So it's quite interesting if we can find out, what can I do with my energy? So my energy, if I can have this speed to create something, how do I go into something? Or is it quite light and slow? Is it a release of energy to pick something up? Do I want the feet to be fast or to be slow? What happens to my energy, holding the energy and releasing that energy? You can do this in the choreography as well. So find out, what are my dynamical qualities? And what do I still need to practice? And get those also better in this piece of choreography, or your choreography that you're gonna dance in the competition. The next decision you can make is about, where is my body in space? So what do I mean by that? Sometimes I use just two words to make it quite clear. And the two words I'm going to give you today are in and out. And I'll explain to you how to actually put that into some choreography. So for example, I can close my feet and I can say the word in. Or I could say the word out. I'll dance it and just see what happens. There's no rules. I can do whatever I want as long as it's clear. In. Out, out, in, and in, out, and in, out, out, and in. So you just have to make a decision, say the words. It's like a kick up the backside to realize, where am I, what am I doing with certain movements? It's actually quite nice to do. So use that as an exercise. You could see there was something different with the rhythm. What I did is I changed my rhythm. This was my rhythm. Still realizing that the music has its own set rhythm. Of course, with different things that we hear in between, but that's not what the lecture is about. My rhythm, what do I do with it? My partner, when we dance together finally after the corona, he has his rhythm. How do they get put together, and how do we dance this to the music? I don't have to Mickey Mouse the music. I can do my rhythm. focus? Which decisions do you have? And which decisions do you make? The decisions that you have are so many, of course, but make a decision about what do I want to show? I'll just give you three from so many that you have. The three decisions that you could use are looking at the audience, sharing what you do with this audience. I can look at the audience and still realize how good my foot is being stretched. So I can share that. Or I can do something that actually looks at my partner. So sharing the focus with the partner. If he's looking back at me or not, that's his decision. But I know where I am looking. Or the decision with myself. So I can put the inner focus, it's inside my body. Not looking down, but I go inside my body. So the posture is still there, but I'm aware, okay, what is happening? Or I can change it to the audience. Or partner, self, and audience. So dance this through and make your choices about where you want to be with the focus. Now we've come to the end of the lecture, and I hope that I've inspired you. And I also hope that you keep practicing your basic fundamentals, but with a little bit of you. Finding out who are you in dance and coming back even stronger. So take care, and obviously I hope that we see each other very, very soon. Big kiss from me.